Well, hello everyone. Welcome to my second video, and glad to see that you're back. So I guess you must have liked what it was. The first one is the one that how I rebooted my record collection. I got a link down in the down under so that you can go and check it out in case you've missed it. This one I'm going to talk about, you know, how do you go about finding what it is you want? If you're a new collector, how do you know what you want? And especially if you don't have, you know, if you're younger and you don't have a long history of what music you might want to listen to. For me, getting started when I rebooted my vinyl collection, one of the first items and records that I wanted to get were the ones I used to own and no longer had. So it was kind of easy to get that list going. For some of you, it might be a little more difficult, or just wondering, you know, what other artists should I be listening to or could give a listen to see if I like. And there are a number of ways of doing that. One thing I recommend that you do, if you're just getting started in this, is that you keep a list of what it is you want and what it is what you already have. That's important. And I keep a number of lists on my phone because they started getting quite long. So I broke them up into genres. So I have, you know, and I have my phone with me wherever I go. So when I go into a record store, I've got those lists on my phone that I can check. And I have just my general, you know, vinyl essentials and alphabetized and got them all in there. So if there are any Elton John titles, for example, that I want, I got an entry for Elton John, and then I've got the names of the different releases that I would like to have that I do not have yet. The list started getting so long that I broke it up into genres. So I've got my general rock and pop music list. I've got one for blues, just blues. I have one for jazz, and I have one for funk and soul. So when I buy a new record or used record, you know, from that list, then I can go in and take it off that list. So that's, you know, one way of doing that. If you are relatively new to collecting, I really recommend that you check out the website Discogs, and there'll be a link to that also down in the down under. And what's nice about this is that you can enter your collection into Discogs so that it's there. So that's another feature, because they have a mobile app, and I can go to my phone when I'm in a record store. And if I'm like, oh man, you know, because, you know, you find stuff that may not necessarily be on your want list, and you can go in there and go, do I already have this? And then you can go look and see if you do. Speaking of want lists, Discogs also has a want list, so you can enter albums that you want to get into that list. Now, I only use the Discog want list for more esoteric titles, rare titles, titles that I have not seen, you know, in record stores in general or very infrequently. So I put them in my want list, because then I will get a periodic email that will show which of the Discog vendors have a particular release available for sale and for how much, and then I can go check it out. So that's another way, you know, of acquiring. It's, you know, a little bit dicey because you're doing this by mail. You cannot necessarily inspect the record before you buy it like you can in a store. So I'm also very cautious about which vendors I will work with. And if I'm disappointed with a vendor, I certainly will not buy anything from them again. But I have made several purchases from Discog vendors and have been very pleased, and so I order from them again. There are YouTubers also who talk about vinyl, and they talk about various, you know, records in their collection. And I will have also links in the Down Under to some of these YouTubers, and some of them include, there's the Daily Vinyl. I really like Bob Bradley and Norman Maslov are two YouTubers who have very interesting vlogs, so to speak. And then also Noble Records, which is the name of the store that this guy operates. But he also does a lot of videos and talks about a lot of different releases. And I've gotten some good ideas of releases that, you know, I hadn't heard of, bands I'd never heard of, and have added them to my list, and I have even acquired a few. So that's another option. There are Facebook groups. Two in particular, one is called Vinyl Discoveries and the other one is called CD Discoveries. They're great groups. And basically, their people are just posting what they're listening to, and then they provide the information about the album or the CD. So you know, and then they make their comments, and then they'll have the information, the artist, the name of the release, the year it was released. Some of them will go into great detail about that. But that's another method of finding out about new music or other releases of artists you do know about, but are not really familiar with their catalog. So that's another great option. Then here's one that I've used, there's always information in a record that you may have that can be helpful to point you in the direction of something new. And the example I'm going to use is the inside of Freak Out. This is a Zappa Records new release, so it's in, you know, in wonderful shape. But on the inside, okay, is this here, all right? And what it says is, these people have contributed materially in many ways to make our music what it is. Please do not hold it against them. So what Zappa did is he lists all these people. And some of them are composers. Some of them are popular singer-songwriters, groups, jazz musicians, and there's some great ideas here. So, for example, I mean, yeah, he's got like, you know, Igor Stravinsky, you know, he's got Bob Dylan, you know, Slim Harpo, you know, great blues musician. So, in Zappa was very much a blues and doo-wop aficionado. One of the names I saw on there was Eric Dolphy. And the only thing I knew about Eric Dolphy was a song on one of Zappa's albums called the Eric Dolphy Memorial Barbecue. And then I saw the name, you know, on Freak Out, and I was like, huh, who is Eric Dolphy? And lo and behold, within a few days of me wondering about this, I was in one of my favorite record stores here in Chicago, and I saw this. It's like, oh my God, Eric Dolphy. It wasn't cheap. This album, it's the it's a I believe it's a original Douglas on the Douglas label. I saw that and I thought, okay, I'm gonna buy it. And this is one of the and I do it once in a while, one of the times that I bought a record not knowing anything about it, other than it seemed to have an endorsement by Frank Zappa. So I figured, okay, it must be all right. And I took it home and it was like, Eric Dolphy is an amazing musician. Bass clarinet player, flute player, other reed instruments, avant-garde jazz, bebop, hard bop jazz. It's great stuff. And since buying that, I've acquired several other Eric Dolphy albums. So that's another way to find out about other artists and maybe what to buy. So as I said, I'm going to have links in the Down Under, and plus a link to my first video, and information about some of the other vloggers that I talked about. So arm yourself with some information. Oh, there are lists that I've used, and I will also have these lists with links, in the Down Under. Rolling Stone has a list of the 500 most influential albums out there. There was one in the New Yorker for the 100, I think, best jazz albums to own. I used that list to create my jazz want list, and I've acquired several releases from that list. And it's a great list because they're all really great recordings. Not all of them are very easy to find, however. So yeah, there are other lists that you can find and use, that are certainly helpful. So, make a list of what you want, even a short list of like the ones that you really urgently want. I have one of those on my phone as well that has about 10 to 12 titles in there that these are the ones I'm really hot to get. And hey, go shopping. And hey, maybe you'll pick up something that's not on your list. And that's perfectly fine. Great way to discover music. And then when you get it home and listen to it, it's like, this is so cool. So thank you. Be sure to check the links down in the Down Under. Hey, like my page and subscribe to it so you'll always be informed about new videos. Plus, check out my Facebook page for these videos. I have other video content and other discussion starting there. I mean, it's a brand new page, so right now there's probably not a lot on it, but it will be having more. So, hey, buy music and enjoy it.